name is Roman Eric from the Android Developer Relations team, and in today's DesignByte, I want to show you how to take an existing icon and flatten it to better match Android's flatter style for things like action bar icons and notification icons. Now, this is a technique that works with raster icons, things like PNGs. Ideally, you'd be starting with vector shapes, you know, things like Illustrator files or vector shapes in Photoshop, and working on those. But in some cases, you simply don't have those source materials. And in some cases, it's actually really hard to replicate the icon using vector shapes. So let's take a look at how to do this in Photoshop, how to take an existing icon and flatten it to better match that style. So the first thing we're going to do is open up an existing graphic here. And we're going to just tweak the setup a little bit to make it a little easier to work with. And we're going to create a new fill layer. It's going to be black, and we're going to put it at the bottom, or I guess below the primary layer. Now, the next step is to merge these two layers. And then go into the curves tool. And this curves tool is going to let you tweak the brightness values of the pixels in your icon. Now, these brightness values will, in the end, become the transparency or alpha values for the final icon. So we'll take our black background and leave that as black. And we'll take this gray and we'll make that the brightest part or the most opaque part of the icon. We'll then select the entire icon, select the entire layer. We'll copy it into the clipboard, and we'll create a new channel. Now, this channel is going to be basically the final alpha channel for our resulting graphic. And we'll paste that graphic that we have in the clipboard into this alpha channel. And this is the big step. The key step here is to then load this alpha channel as a selection, and that's going to be using this button at the bottom right here. Now, once we have that alpha channel loaded into a selection, we can go back into the layers palette and create a new layer, and then simply fill our selection with a foreground color. Now, this foreground color should depend entirely on your needs. If you're creating an action bar icon and you're using the normal hollow dark and hollow light styling, then you can get the right color and opacity values from the action bar iconography section in the design guide. Or if you're trying to use a different color that better matches your brand, this is the point at which you can put that in. So then we'll simply fill the selection and then deselect our selection and then get rid of the original icon. And that's it. What we're left with is basically a layer. You can turn this into a smart object to resize it down to smaller sizes. But we're left with a layer that has a single foreground color with no special effects or anything like that. And we can use this as potentially source material for smaller icons. And that's it for today's very quick DesignByte on how to use Photoshop to take an existing icon and flatten it.